It's coming to that beautiful time of year. You've been going bear mode, packing on size, maybe even gotten a little bit fat.
Dude, we've been through this, okay? I'm cultivating mass.
Okay, my bad. I got it. Anyways, you built up a solid amount of muscle over the past few months, and now it's time to shed that adipose overcoat so you can show off your newly earned buys and tries to all the other girls and guys. But you gotta be careful, because if you cut weight the wrong way, you'll end up losing a good amount of that beautiful contractile tissue that you carefully accumulated. Meaning those hundreds of chickens that sacrificed themselves so you could chow down on their amino acid rich breasts died for nothing. And as a proud member of PETA, I can't stand for that. So in this video, I'm gonna teach you how to cut fat while losing as little muscle as possible. Don't diet too aggressively and be patient. Oftentimes, when people start a new meal plan or diet, they're highly motivated and want to see results as soon as possible. And because of this, they put themselves into a super large caloric deficit, potentially eating 1,000 calories or more under what they need to maintain their weight. This will lead to them losing weight in the short term, but the body is smart and it'll go to great lengths to make sure you don't off yourself. So it'll start to make some budget cuts to adapt to the new amount of energy that's coming in. And you know what's one of the first things to go? That's right, those beautiful muscles you've worked so hard to build. Okay, imagine it like this. You're making $100,000 a year. You're feeling good. You're feeling like a baller. But then Bernie gets elected and poses an 80% wealth tax so that the federal government can fund their new bird feeder initiative. So just like your body would, when faced with a sudden large decrease in resources, you have to cut your expenses. Suddenly that $500 a month testosterone shipment from our boy Greg isn't looking so sexy anymore. Now, to avoid this problem, aim to be in a slight caloric deficit of about 200 to 500 calories a day, depending on how much fat you have to lose. Try not to drop more than 0.5 to 1% of your overall body mass per week. This will help make sure that your body doesn't panic and shed any muscle mass in an attempt to adapt. If you guys are liking the video and my ridiculous analogies, please subscribe and leave a like so you can enjoy more ridiculous educational fitness content in the future. Don't completely change your training. Okay, so think about this. There's this thing called the SAID principle, specific adaptations to imposed demands. Your body will adapt to a stressor in a specific way to better deal with that stressor in the future. So with a stressor like weightlifting, your muscles will become bigger and stronger so that you can better handle the stress of being made fun of for benching less than 225. So you can better handle the intensity and volume of training in the future. Yeah, that's what I meant to say. But since maintaining muscle mass is very energy intensive for the body, it'll only hold onto it as long as there's a reason, especially when your body is low on resources, like during a cut. So if you start a cut and start doing an hour of cardio instead of your weights, your body no longer has a good reason to hold on to all that lean mass. So while cutting, try to maintain a similar amount of volume of weightlifting as to when you were bulking. It's okay for the weight and volume to be slightly lower, but just try to maintain things as best as you can. It can be helpful to add some cardio sessions to help create that ever important calorie deficit, but try to keep the amount of time you're doing cardio to less than half the amount of time that you're doing your weights. That's a good rough rule to go off of. Eat a large amount of protein. Not only will eating a large amount of protein help keep you full and satiated, but it'll also give your body the necessary resources to hold on to all that lean mass during a cut. Try to aim for 1 gram of protein per pound of body mass. Don't waste your macros and calories on junk. Sure, you can get shredded if you hit your macros, even if it's mostly just from mutant mass protein and Pop-Tarts, but it'll leave your body short on essential micronutrients that are needed for proper bodily function. And like we talked about earlier, a big part of maintaining muscle mass in a cut is keeping up your weight training volumes. That's gonna be a really hard thing to do if you feel like trash because you're not only in a caloric deficit, but you're also deficient in multiple important micros like zinc, calcium, and iron. So what's the easiest way of getting all your micros without taking a million supplements every day? Eat high quality meats, especially red meat and fish, and eat the rainbow. Okay, not that rainbow, a rainbow of veggies and fruits. Different fruits and veggies have different micronutrients, so by eating a variety, it'll help cover all your bases. That's the video, hope you enjoyed it. Hit me with your questions down in the comments, and I'll see you there.